Hi, folks, and welcome to my Ask Shell Coffee Break. Today, we're going to talk about those heated floors in the basement. Radiant heat. Radiant heat that's given off from a boiler through a piping system. Could be PEX pipe or could be copper pipe. Could be even an older pipe system of galvanized. But in any event, radiant heating in a concrete floor, and it could be even an older home, say 50 years old. So I have a number of cases where people will call and ask a question, why is my concrete on the basement floor system starting to crumble? Now, when I get a question like that, I have to ask a question back. And this is why it's so interesting to be able to come to you via the coffee break to have you ask the question while you're watching this. How do you know that you have a problem with the concrete if the concrete is covered, say, with carpet or laminate flooring or tile, for an example, or even sheet linoleum or vinyl? Well, you'll normally see a hump in the floor. And a hump in the floor under carpet is very simple to get at. All you have to do is unhook the carpet and roll it back, roll the underpad back. May not even have underpad. It may be some of the older indoor-outdoor with the foam back. But in any event, you see this hump, you roll the carpet back. You can assume the same thing is taking place under laminate flooring as well as tile or vinyl or linoleum. So what is causing the problem is this. The heat, the radiant heat in the floor and also under the floor, you can almost guarantee there's no polyethylene before they place the concrete there in place for the concrete surface floor. And that being the case, moisture will over the years migrate by wicking up through the concrete. And when that takes place, it'll come to the top and vent itself out through the top of the concrete. And invariably, that concrete, the alkaline in the concrete, will pop the concrete surface off. And you'll end up with a lot of loose, white-colored powder, for an example, and the concrete that chipping, we call it spalling. Now, when that happens, that's telling you that you've got problems under your slab with water. And you got to be very cautious at this particular time, because if you have carpet, it's very simple to repair. If you have laminate flooring or hardwood flooring or tile or sheet vinyl, it's not that easy, because you'll have to damage the product when you remove it or take it up. But with the moisture problem, it's obviously indicating that you've got a drainage problem around your perimeter drainage around your home, or the weeping tile. Some people will call it weeping tile, or a sump that's not working properly, or water's not getting to the sump to get away to the storm sewer, to get away to the drainage area outside the home. So when you bring this to a point of repair is what I'd like to deal with. Obviously, if you've got a water problem, you're going to have to correct it, okay? You can use people like basement systems. You can use people like drainage people that will take care of that. Every city, we have them available through our House Smart Home Service referral. So anytime you have that problem, get in touch with us, and you know how to do that because you're a member of our club. But when you have the problem, you'll have to take and scrape all that concrete surface away. Vacuum it clean. Once you've done that, then you take a product that is going to be a bonding agent as well as a cementitious cement repair product. So bonded topping mix is one. Top and bond is another one. And all of those products require your attention to apply properly. And that's what I'd like to make reference to. When you do repair concrete, you always, always want to use a product like Weld Bond. It's a multi-purpose wood adhesive of all things. And you apply it full strength right on top of the area where it's chipped away. And you don't have to wait for it to dry. You can mix up the bonded topping mix or the topping bond and apply it right into the cavity, just like filling a tooth or filling any wood hole with a wood putty, and scribe it off with a trowel nice and smooth. Let that dry, or cure as we use the term, and then back with your underpad and back with your carpet or whatever flooring that you have on top. Keeping in mind, one, you got to correct the drainage. Two, correct that by repairing the concrete surface with the bonding agent, top and bond, or bonded topping mix. Once you've done that, you've got it all finished. And it was just that easy, wasn't it?